guys, for this video I'm going to be reacting to Roman Reigns on Miz TV from Monday Night Raw.
Roman!
So we've got, Roman in the ring with Mr. Rage.
Mr. Undertaker at WrestleMania. And then you had an equally impressive victory last night against John Cena. And on Raw Talk, John Cena said about this match that it was a passing of the torch moment. How do you feel hearing that come from a person like John Cena?
Since you're pretty long-winded, and I'm going to cut to the chase and tell you I respect John Cena now.
No, they hated each other about
it. He did it for 15 years.
Now Roman respects him.
He's
kissing his ass.
There's not another top guy that can say that. So yes, I respect John Cena, and that's why I'm proud to say that I beat John Cena last night. And if I'm gonna be honest, it was the biggest win I've ever had in my entire career. So you weren't the only one celebrating all night. It's been a long night. I don't have a lot of sleep. My back hurts from the match, and I really don't understand why I'm sitting here talking to an idiot like you.
An idiot like me. I mean, why would Roman Reigns talk to little old Miz? Because you're the guy. You know who the guy is? The guy in the ring with the championship. Because at No Mercy, I single-handedly retained my Intercontinental Champion, making the most prestigious and honorable title in all the WWE.
He's almost got a point in the fact that the Universal title isn't defended or not.
Exactly what I said Jason Jordan is.
It is like the main title on Raw.
Yeah, I'm that guy.
A loser. I've been in the ring with you, and I've been in the ring with Jason Jordan. And I'm telling you right now, he's a thoroughbred, and you could not beat him one-on-one.
Oh, nice. Again, saying a word, idiots.
Matter of fact, why don't y'all help me? Why don't y'all run back there and grab me a beverage or something?
It's kind of ironic coming from you talking about the Miztourage, Bo Dallas, and Curtis Axel, because when you first came to WWE, you rode the coattails of two superstars. And if the Miztourage was around 5 years ago, nobody would remember the Shield.
Masturbatable.
Do you know what would happen if the Miztourage faced the Shield?
We would whoop y'all's ass, no problem.
People are now beginning to cheer for Roman a little bit, yeah.
I don't want that, and you're not going to get it.
That's a shame.
Dean and Seth are doing their thing, and I'm doing mine. And I have my own direction.
Now the Bruce is starting again.
So that means I'm coming after the Beast.
I invite you onto my show, and you disrespect the Miztourage, my brothers, and then you go about disrespecting me by talking about another champion in front of me. You beat John Cena once. Great. But what about all the times that you choked? You think we all forgot about when you got pinned by Brock Lesnar at SummerSlam? You've never been Universal Champion, yet you act like all of us are beneath you. Let me explain something to you.
Well, I'm just starting to get serious now. Thank you for that.
Thank you for the show. Thank you, everyone. Miztourage, let's go. Tell Maurice you can be home a little late tonight.
Oh, no, where's my angles at?
The idea of a match between you and Roman Reigns tonight. Oh, yeah.
Oh, Lesnar, basically. But he's ended up facing Roman Reigns. And, next week on Raw, they're going to have an Intercontinental title match. Which I hope to God Roman doesn't win. But we'll see what happens. So thanks for watching this video.